Regular clinical trials run a bit like trains on train tracks. Everything is pretty much fixed from the beginning to the end. The design, the treatments you offer, and how many people you will enroll are all locked in before the first person is enrolled. You do the trial and then you look at the data at the end to see if you've answered your question. Sometimes the trial fails to reach an answer because we have had to make assumptions or guesses about the patients and their responses to treatment, and those guesses have turned out to be wrong. Adaptive trials are different. Instead of being like a train on tracks, an adaptive trial is more like setting out on a hike with a map and a compass. You know where you want to end up, but the exact path that you will take depends on the conditions that you encounter on the way. You can adapt the design, how many people you will enroll, and how many people receive each of the treatments being evaluated while the trial is running. The adaptations are made according to rules, based on the data or the information that we collect from patients already in the study, by observing how well they have responded to the various treatments. There are more possibilities with adaptive designs. Over time, we can assign more participants to whichever treatments appear to be performing best, and fewer participants to those treatments which are not performing as well. We can also eliminate any treatments as soon as it's clear that they're not best, or it's clear that they are less safe than other alternatives. Eliminating inferior treatments means that we might be able to introduce new treatments that become available. While regular fixed trials assess the average effect of treatments for an average patient across the whole trial group, adaptive processes can be used to learn which treatments are best for different types of patients. We think that because of their flexibility, the adaptive approach is a better way of doing trials, and that they will become the future of clinical research. We think that they're fairer for participants and can greatly improve the efficiency of research, allowing clinicians and researchers to answer increasingly complex questions faster.